do you actually pin things on Pinterest? Now, I know this might seem like a silly question, but if it's your first time on Pinterest and you're wondering, oh my gosh, I don't even know how this thing works. Well, you're in the right place because I'm gonna show you how it works. Now, things are gonna look a little bit different if you are using the Pinterest mobile app and not just the regular Pinterest desktop experience. And 80% of people who use Pinterest are on mobile, so it is likely you are doing this on your phone. But pretty much everything is the same. It's just gonna look a little bit different. Instead of it being horizontal, it's gonna be more vertical if you're doing this on your phone. So I've set up a new account here and I've set up my first board and I want to start adding pins to it. Now, if you are interested in learning more about how Pinterest works, I have a whole series here and there is a link to it. If you click the I button up here in the corner, there is a link to the video series playlist that walks you all the way through start to finish how to create a Pinterest account. And this is great for saving your own ideas. But if you're a business, this is even better because this is how to set up your account from A to Z from the very beginning in the right way. Now, I've set up this account as a business account because this is a website that I have all about tamales. If you do not have a business, you don't have to set up a business account, but it's actually pretty cool because you get to see a lot more information about Pinterest if you have the business account. So even if you're not a business, it's just good to be aware that there is the business account option. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. I created this chicken tamales board. If you don't have any boards yet, you're gonna wanna make sure that you go ahead and do create a board. So I'm gonna click the P button up here at the top, and that is going to take me to the main feed. This is called the smart feed. This is where Pinterest takes the interest that you told it you have and it serves up information to you all based on what you said you were interested in. So I said I was interested in desserts, drinks, food and recipes, quotes, and I think I also said memes, and so I got memes. And so Pinterest is saying, hey, you're interested in this? We're gonna share this kind of stuff with you. Now, the more that you pin and the more that you interact with and search on Pinterest, the more Pinterest gets an idea of what you're interested in. So it's gonna show you more and more things that you're interested in here in the smart feed. From here, I wanna go ahead and start searching for some things to pin because I don't see any tamales right here and my first board is all about chicken tamales. So I'm gonna go ahead and type here in the search bar. I'm gonna type chicken tamale. And from here, I'm gonna look at all the results and I can scroll and pin different ones. So I'm gonna pin this one. And to pin something, you just hover over it. And if you're on mobile, you just put your finger over it and there is a button called save. So I can click save and then I can save it to my board, or Pinterest gives me a list of additional boards that it thinks I should save this to based on this pin, where it's been saved before, etc. So maybe I see tamales and I wasn't looking for tamales and I'm like, oh my gosh, I totally need to save that tamale recipe. It will help me make a board based on that, which is pretty darn cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and save it to my chicken tamales board. From there, I can keep scrolling to look at other tamale recipes, or I can click on this pin and it's gonna open itself up and give me all kinds of good information. It's gonna give me a call to action where I can go and visit that website and get the recipe, which, hey, it happens to be my website, one of my other websites. But what I wanna do is look down here because anytime you open up a pin, I can see more stuff like the thing that I just pinned. So I could pin all of these there too. Now, the kind of pins that are gonna do the best on Pinterest are the ones that catch your eye. So as you are thinking about creating pins, like maybe you wanna put pins on here, you wanna pin ones that catch your eye. Like this looks really yummy, so I'm gonna save that because that looks delicious. Look at the pins that catch your eye, and then when you start creating your own pins, those are the kinds of images that you should do. Like that one looks delicious. Okay, so I hope that this was helpful for you. Now in the next video, I'm gonna show you some tips about how to navigate around on Pinterest because there's lots of cool stuff to see, but maybe you're not sure what that button does. And so I'm gonna walk you through what the different buttons on Pinterest do and show you how to find your way around. Now, if this video was helpful to you, please tag a friend down in the comments, hit that share button and share it on social media because sharing is caring. And if you have a friend that's struggling with Pinterest or maybe they own a business, this video can absolutely help them have a better experience and get better results on Pinterest. Now, this is part of a video series, so to see the next video in the series, click on the video that is playing in the end card of this video and it will take you to the next video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.